So I'm going to finally review the Bare Minerals Bare Skin Pure Brightening Serum Foundation, and this is most likely a first impression. I used it yesterday just for application reasons to see how it worked if I did not use it with the brush that they recommend you buy it with. And this is the Bare Minerals Perfecting Face Brush. It's a flat top brush that has a cutout in the middle of it, which is very interesting. It's super soft. I just opened it right now, so this will be a first impression of this combination together. I have shade Bare Beige 8, and there are 20 different shades on Sephora's website, which is a lot of shades. It retails for $29, and like I said, I have the 8th shade, so there's still plenty after me and a couple before me. I'm really hoping that this does work out. It looked fine the few times I tried it onto certain areas of my face, but we'll see. The instructions say to shake well for a perfect mix of ingredients. Dab one drop of foundation into the brush reservoir and start with one drop. Buff onto the skin and repeat only if you desire more coverage. A little goes a long way. Buff onto the skin in circular motions and add drops to intense. Okay. It says you need to try using a primer before using it. Blah, 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 blah. Okay. And use a finishing powder to lock your foundation in place. So I'm just gonna use the Bare Minerals Primetime Original. I got this at Gen Beauty. And it should work well though, because it is a Bare Minerals primer. I'm gonna do one drop. It's very hard to actually squeeze the bottle because the bottle's hard. So one drop. This is what it looks like. How is this supposed to work? It's a little weird. Didn't really do anything. It kind of just sunk into the brush. I don't really know how this brush is supposed to be working. A huge glob in the middle of the brush. It's a couple drops in my opinion, but okay. But definitely more even. Oh, it does match me. So I've tried it with another brush, and I must say I really didn't care for it that much. So I'm just going to use my fingers for the other side of my face, just to see how that goes. Oh my god, it's so hard to squeeze this bottle. Woohoo! It'll work really, really fast. Nah, it looks kind of streaky, so we're going to go back with the brush. Trying to work fast before it sinks into the brush. I mean, it's not too bad. It just looks like your typical foundation. But if you're thinking bare skin, I don't know if it's because I end up using more than needed. But otherwise, it wasn't showing up at all on my face. But on certain areas where I feel like, you know, I'm a little bit more poreless, it looks a lot better. Like my chin area. Let's zoom in on certain things. Okay, so we're in the nose area right now. You can see it. It's not too bad. I did use primer. And then the chin. I have no breakouts right now, so I can't say I'm having that much of issues, but I definitely think you can see it. You can still see some acne scars, but I'm not trying to build it to full coverage. I want it to be like a nice medium, a light medium. Did I mention that the brush is $28? So to get this paired together, you would have to spend $57. We are going to take a picture to make sure it looks good because there is SPF 20. Oh, it looks very good on camera for SPF 20. There isn't like a dramatic white cast, and this is without powder, so you can kind of see it has a very nice natural dewy finish to it. But I heard it's not very good for oily skin, so definitely use a finishing powder. I'm not gonna even try because it doesn't say it's gonna control my oils whatsoever. Do I look fabulous? Yeah, it looks really good. I'm gonna use a Sephora powder. It's 1 o'clock in the afternoon right now, so we will wear this for a while and check back later. So we are back. It has been a total of 7 hours, and that's as long as I'm going today, guys. Sorry. I already went to Target. I did a lot of things. Went out in the heat. Here I am. Okay, I got a little eyeshadow fallout. I didn't really dust it away. Oops. My nose. It's just one tiny spot that looks like it's gone. Everything else looks okay. It's a little cakey right here. Still looks pretty good. I feel like it transfers really easily. It definitely transfers really easily. So I think that's why my face is looking a little patchy. Zoom you guys back out, and there we go. I mean, it's not too bad. Oh, by the way, a makeup tutorial is coming very soon of this extremely blue look. You see that blue eyeliner? Bold girl. It's okay. I'm not saying this is a life-changing foundation, though. I feel like my face looks a little splotchy. Definitely is okay with a powder. It doesn't look bad. It looks pretty healthy, and it photographs well. For sure. So, if I have to put a little pro and con list to you guys right now, pros. The price is decently reasonable for things in Sephora. There are 20 different shades. Has SPF 20. Feels lightweight on the face. Blends pretty well. Photographs and films very well. And with a powder, has a decent oil control. Well, I don't really think that's the powder. I don't think that's the foundation. It's most likely the powder that you choose. But yes, I think it does look a lot better with a primer than without, but it still doesn't look like skin, in my opinion, so that's a con. The fact that if you forget your powder, you are going to be screwed if you have oily skin, that's a con. The brush, I didn't really understand fully. You guys saw my reaction to that, so I don't really know how I feel about this whole system, per se. Work fast, because it sets really fast. It doesn't sink in the fine lines or pores, though. That's a good thing, so... That's my little sum up for you, but it does transfer pretty badly. What can I say? That is my first impression review on the Benefit. Did I just say Benefit? The Bare Minerals Bare Skin Foundation. I have a lot of new reviews already up for you guys. There was the Maybelline new BB cream, which was right before this, and I'll link that off at the end of this video if you've missed it. I'll see you guys later.